you want to do, the more we want to do. New COVID-19 boosters designed for recent Omicron variants are now available. Learn about eligibility and schedule a free updated booster today at vaccines.gov. Sponsored by Pfizer and BioNTech.
NBA fans, it's time to bring the hoops action to the palm of your hand with DraftKings Sportsbook, an official sports betting partner of the NBA. This week, new customers can bet $5 and win $200 in free bets instantly. Download the app now and sign up with code IHEART. New customers can bet $5 on the NBA and get $200 in free bets instantly. At DraftKings Sportsbook, an official sports betting partner of the NBA. Code I. 21 and over in most eligible states, but age varies by jurisdiction. Void in Ontario and Ohio. Bonus issued as free bets. Opt-in required. Eligibility, wagering, and deposit restrictions apply. Terms at sportsbook.draftkings.com/basketball terms. See draftkings.com/sportsbook for details and state-specific responsible gambling resources. Gambling problem? Call 1-800-GAMBLER. That's 1-800-426-2537. In New York, call 877-8-HOPE-NY or text HOPE-NY 467-369.
Nickelback, the guest. Ansley Gilbert and Josh Ross. Get tickets now.
When you stay at a Vrbo, the host doesn't stay with you. Because a vacation home with a stranger sounds a little bit like a horror movie. Only whole vacation homes, always private. Book on the Vrbo app.
Business today looks nothing like it did yesterday. While it's more unpredictable, its possibilities are endless. At ADP, turning unpredictability into an advantage is what we do. Using data-driven insights, we design HR solutions to help businesses work better, smarter, so they can think beyond today and find even more success tomorrow. HR, time, talent, benefits, payroll. ADP, always designing for people.
Don't miss Ashley's President's Day preview sale going on now. This week only, beat the crowds and get early access to the best President's Day deals, including 10% off trending styles throughout the store and online. And with special financing options available for all budgets, refreshing your home has never been easier. Hurry into your local Ashley store or tap the banner to shop and save today. Only at America's number one furniture and mattress store, Ashley. See store or ashley.com for details.
What if there was a university on the train? An accounting class under the one shady spot at soccer practice? Imagine if every waiting room was actually a classroom. What if you could pick the time and the place that works for you, and college would just appear? UMass Global offers 100% online classes, short 8-week courses, and personalized support to help you succeed in college, wherever you are in life. Major in your future. Visit umassglobal.edu to apply.
Dancing crew, trip for brand new mug. Come here, kid, give me a hug. The more you want to do, the more we want to do. New COVID-19 boosters designed for recent Omicron variants are now available. Learn about eligibility and schedule a free updated booster today at vaccines.gov. Sponsored by Pfizer and BioNTech.
iHeartRadio Earth is here with little tips for a healthier planet. Farming meat accounts for 14% of global greenhouse gas emissions, the same as all modes of transportation combined. Help reduce the impact your meals have on the environment by going meatless one day a week. When we all chip in, our world becomes a better place. Brought to you by iHeartRadio Earth and the National Environmental Education Foundation. To find more tips for small, sustainable living or to take action in your own community, go to iHeartRadio.com/earth.
It's Jesse. I just want to congratulate you on your nuptials and give you a little piece of advice that has helped me throughout my marriage. One thing women love is when they're upset, tell them to calm down. It's like a horse. It just soothes them, and then they're putty in your hands. Use this. It'll serve you well.
So
thank you, Jesse Kelly. Wisdom from on high, all, you know, 8 feet up in the air there from Jesse. I would say one thing that I have picked up on, both in my life as just a man interacting with women and also in a lot of the advice, is to know the difference between when your wife, Clay, and I want you to tell me if this is correct, and I know that the true expert, Mrs. Clay Travis, is listening, so she can text you the correct answer because she can hear this, but whether you can discern if when a woman tells you a problem, you are just supposed to say, oh, that sucks, man, that's annoying, or, you know, whatever it may, or, hey, I have some solutions, including the telling you it's not that big a deal, we can handle this. Like, apparently discerning between those two pathways is very important, I am told.
Yes, and if you figure out how to do that, because you can give me tips. Jesse's advice is really funny. But yeah, you're right. So much of... This is not speaking specifically to my marriage. So much of women is wanting you to think the things that they want you to think. But then also recognizing that that is impossible for you to do is a big part. Because I guarantee you, every single husband listening to me right now has oftentimes made decisions that are the opposite of what he would do, because he's trying to think what his wife would do in that situation, right? Like, I can't tell you the number of times I have had a decision to make, oftentimes involving children, and I don't even think, okay, how would I solve this? I just immediately cast that aside and don't even contemplate it at all. And then try to put myself into her head and solve the issue as she would solve it, meaning I'm making choices completely not mine, and still oftentimes get it wrong, right? So that is the challenge. The other thing that you will get used to is when she says, are you going to wear that? The answer is generally not yes. And the number of men out there that know what I'm talking about, you walk out, you know, you are dressed, you think that you are ready to go, and your wife says, are you going to wear that? She's not actually asking if you're going to wear that. She's telling you, you should be changing what you are wearing. Just turn around and go right back into the closet and put something on. Because of late, Buck, maybe it's just me, I wear those Tommy John pants that we got, like, to every event that I possibly can. Have you noticed these men's pants? That they're, my wife calls them like the equivalent of the yoga pants for men. They're not tight like yoga pants are on women, but they have like the, you wear them all the time too.
I only wear performance fabric. Not that I'm a physical performer. But.
Yeah, I would say that they are like athletic sweatpants is a way to describe them out there. They basically, like, they have a little bit of a touch.
It's a synthetic material mixed in with the cotton or the wool.
And they're usually tied around the ankles. For people out there who may not know what I'm talking about, I'm going to wear those pants, I think, exclusively to everything almost for the rest of my life. Like, I don't want to go full Fetterman here, but I don't know why anybody would wear these pants if they have the opportunity. If you're a man and you're not wearing these pants, I don't know what you're doing with your life.
I mean, some people are going to think that this is a little too out there on the edge. I am not wearing a tie to my wedding. I'm wearing a suit and a button down and, you know, dress shoes. I'm not wearing a tie. Why do I want to wear a tie? Tie is uncomfortable.
You are really anti-tie. What about a bow tie?
I'm very anti-tie. Also, because I think I associate the tie, because I went to school for 10 years, a Catholic school in New York, where you had to wear jacket and tie, and they wouldn't even let you unbutton the top button under it. That was like a demerit. You'd get into trouble. And then later on in life, I actually, in the CIA, our office was jacket and tie for a while, the Iraq office. So people, if I remember correctly, I remember wearing, certainly for briefings and things, we had to wear a suit and tie. I viewed the tie as
the man,
some kind of
the man coming down on.
Yeah, it's the man grabbing my throat, not letting me breathe freely. It's almost like how I view masks. I'm not gonna, maybe that's why I hated masks so much.
Speaking of hating, do we have the picture up of me at my wedding?
Wow. By the way, everybody, you it's have got
haircut.
To see. It
bad
is an amazing, haircut. I don't even know all the details. It is an amazing love story between Clay and his wife, because she went through with the wedding, and obviously they've been happily married now for 20 plus years with three kids. She went through with the wedding despite the haircut that Clay had, which I've got to tell you, it was a doozy.
It is really an atrocious haircut to have gotten right before the wedding. And immediately when I mentioned that, Allie was like, oh, I'm going to see it. We have an important caller right now. I'm not sure who this is.
Hello?
Hello?
Yes.
Hey, Buck, Joe, how you doing?
Hi, Joe. This is Mr. Flatley.
Future father-in-law.
Future father-in-law, Joe. Yes, sir. How are you?
I'm doing well. We're just scooting down the turnpike here, coming to have fun. We're doing.
What do you think? What do you think about becoming a your daughter is going to get married? Are you super nervous about walking down the aisle? You've got this has got kind of a big moment for you emotionally, right? Have you thought about what that's going to feel like?
I don't think nervous. You know, yeah, there's going to be a probably yeah. I mean, it'll be great. Some exhilaration. Happy for Carrie and Buck and. Yeah, I'm not feeling nervous about it at all.
Captain Flatley's already, he's marched one daughter down the aisle, so he's okay, got some experience.
Right. So, by the way, you actually are kind of an in this. You are a pilot. You now are a commercial pilot, but before that, you were a badass, you know, Top Gun instructor. What do you think about this Chinese spy balloon just floating across the country right now? And what do you think the guys in the Air Force and in the Top Gun community are thinking about this?
I really don't know. I think there's, I was just talking to Bridget as we're driving down the road here, thinking, maybe they're just, they're data collecting. Maybe we're just sending them bad data. You know, we're just misinforming them or something, and maybe having fun with them or trying to get in. I don't know. But I don't know what to think of it. It seems that we should be doing more than sitting on our thumbs and letting it go, but or maybe they're figure out what to do with it. But yeah, to be honest, I don't know what to think about it. It's strange that we're just letting it go on without. But they must. We must know something, and we're doing something about it. But they're just not telling the public.
Well, I know if we suited up Captain Flatley, put him in an F-15, the Commander Chief told him to. But Joe, thank you.
F-18s. We'll leave those F-15s in the Air Force. So.
Oh, there we go. That's right, F-18. Thank you for letting me marry your daughter. I'm very excited. I love her very much, and I'm to walk down the aisle. I guess I stand at the front of the aisle, but we're going through the rehearsal later today, so I'll have all that squared away, sir, I promise.
Yeah, me too. Hopefully I don't screw it up. But, I tell you what, you know, I'm obviously a little biased, but you got a good one. She's her mother's daughter, and Bridget raised a good one. Raised a few four good ones. So, yeah, you're gonna have a good life with Kara. She's a good one. So
it's gonna be all Clay and Jesse have separately told me lock it up early on here. So there we go. So we got a lot of reinforcement on Carrie's amazing. Thank you, Joe, and I'll see you in a little bit.
All right. Yeah. To see you.
Yes, sir. Well, the father of the bride, man, my father-in-law. You chime in whatever you like, sir. Sir, yes, sir. Whatever you say, I'm there for you. Clay, when families come together for memorable events like my wedding tomorrow, there's no shortage of pictures and video taken. Now, today, everyone's got their phones. They're capturing every moment. But back 20 or 30 years ago, it wasn't that easy. Videotapes in your family's collection from back in the day are probably still stored away. Those VHS tapes, all the rest of it. If your family has a box or two of them, those need to be digitized before the tape disintegrates, which it will after about 20 years or so. That's where Legacy Box comes in. They digitally transfer all those memories for you. They've been doing it for over a decade for over a million families. You can ship all those tapes to Legacy Box. Once received, the technicians at Legacy Box digitally transfer everything by hand. In 3 weeks' time, you get digital files you can store in the cloud, share with members, and hold on to forever, watching easily over and over again.
Become your family's hero with your family's memories before it's too late. Go to legacybox.com/buck. You'll get a huge discount. Legacybox.com/BUCK.
Subscribe to CNB 24/7 and never miss a minute of Clay and Buck while getting behind-the-scene access to special content for members only.
Power Talk 14.6 FM 101.1.
Binge listen this and all your artist stations, plus any song from our library of millions of songs, all ad-free. Get your free 30-day trial of iHeartRadio All Access. You'll love it. Don't be basic. Be extra. Start your free 30-day trial of iHeartRadio All Access now.
Nickelback, the Geb Rowland Tour. With Brantley Gilbert and Josh Ross. Get tickets now. Here are the top Aerosmith songs that you've thumbed up. Number 3, Ragdoll. Ragdoll, living in a movie. Daddy's in a cutie. So fine, I never see the leaving. Dream On. Number 1, Sweet Emotion. Similar artists now. Sirius Radio. All your favorite music, all your favorite stations, all free.
All the good stuff. Yeah. Rufio keeps you on top of pop culture.
Rihanna and Apple are teaming up for the Super Bowl halftime show, a first for both, and they aren't going to do it low-key. Apple announced they will offer up Rihanna's Road to Halftime, 2 weeks of Rihanna-centric programming for subscribers. Also featured a roundtable discussion of Rihanna's cultural impact, NFL playlists from the weight room to the locker room, and tons more special NFL and Rihanna-oriented content.
And that's what's poppin'.
I'm Rufio on iHeartRadio.
iHeartRadio.
Here are the top John Mellencamp songs that you've thumbed up.
Number 3. Hurts So Good.
Pretty good.
How can I help you?
I think I'm just gonna need an oil change.
Oil change?
Yeah.
Okay, I'll be right back so I can check you in, okay?
Oh, okay, cool.
Number 1.
Okay. Oh.